What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Mass Effect 2. We're here with Atticus, Leora, and Garrus. We are in the middle of a combat situation, and we are trekking to find the Shadow Broker. Yes, the damn Shadow Broker. I know, it's still kind of hard to believe that we're actually going to probably see the Shadow Broker here very shortly. But let's look at the journal, see if anything did come up. The Shadow Broker's base has finally been located on the stormy planet of Hagalas. Leora asked for assistance in finishing the Shadow Broker off for good. Use the hash to enter the Shadow Broker's base. We are in the base. We are starting some ruckus. Let's do it. Whoa! Come on, mother effers. Holy shit, that was close. Shepard, that ran. That rocket ran right by your head. Actually, I'm thinking we get the... There we go. Let's get snipes out for this. Oh, we shot him right in the dangle. We're gonna need to move up some here.
Shield your eyes.
I'm on it.
Anything for you. There it is.
Enemy!
There we go. Everyone's moving up. Leora, be careful. She just said, fuck it, I'm going. Actually, let's change weapons. Because Leora's on pistol and Garrus is on assault rifle. There we go.
Stasis field ready.
Sucker! Let's keep on going. We're going to meet the Shadow Broker. What the fuck? I'm still going on the theory that it's some kind of AI.
Got hostile drones.
It would really kind of make sense, wouldn't it? Heavy weapons? No. Not heavy weapons yet. We'll probably need that. Damn, Garrus. You done whoop. His whole shield. We don't really have the... Excuse me, Leora.
Look out! Light him up.
Light him up then. We don't have the best cover here. There it is. Anyone else want some? Yep.
Watch out, flashbangs.
Eat that. Is that a... Damn, good throw. Jeez. Yeah, the damage, a little tiny damage buff. I wouldn't even call it tiny, actually. A damage buff when stasis ends for sure. Another one.
Watch for biotics. Freeze.
Oh, we just missed her. That's fine, Leora. You did fine. That Asari is pissed at Leora.
Impressive.
Gotcha. Snipe that one.
Okay.
Fire in the hole.
Keep it up. Oh, that was a save right there? Damn, I guess we could have came in. We could have totally came in the ship, blew up a few people, and then saved peacefully. That's fine. Who would have known, though, you know? Let's see, can we do something with that? Okay, let's keep on going, shall we? Let's look at the map, though. This just got us going straight. Find the Shadow Broker at all costs.
I've downloaded the ship's layout. We're headed toward the prison block. And Farron.
You know, I'm really interested to see how Leora and Farron are. I said I'm not worried, but... I mean, anybody in their right mind would have a flicker of wonder, of course. But I truly ain't worried. It just... I'm curious how the relationship actually is. What is... Where the fuck did you come from?
Enemy
send him back
drone.
To... There we go, Garrus. Send them back to hell. There's someone over there. Wait.
Charging biotics.
Come on, fall, sucker. You know you want to.
Scoped and dropped.
Scoped them and then dropped them. Somebody in here?
Fire oh, there is.
Where'd he go? Get up! Garrus. You wrecked him! Oh, there's the door to get out of here. Examine the door. Oh! There he is! There's Farron! He's got some shit going on, Liara. He looks like he is attached to some kind of torture device, maybe? Access terminal. Oh. Let us in. Farron needs to be saved. Here, here. There, there.
Farron.
Liara?
Hold on. We're getting you out of here.
No.
Farron.
The broker's trapped in? Are you okay? Yeah, you alright? Liara is pretty shocked to see you in that chair, to say the least.
What the hell is the broker trying to do to you?
The equipment is sensitive to tampering. This chair plugs into the broker's info network. You have to shut off the power. Pull me out now and my brain cooks.
Do you know where we can cut the power?
It won't be easy. You'll have to go to central operations.
Your prison? The guards? The Shadow Broker? Let's dig, yeah?
What's the point of this cage?
I don't know.
It's a neural grounding rod. The medical equipment is to make sure he doesn't expire. We have to shut this place down.
Damn, so he's keeping him alive just to torture him? He, she, it, whatever it is. The broker, let's just say the broker. The guards.
Where did the broker get the mercs?
Raised his own private force. They're completely loyal.
Shepard, we really don't have the time.
I need to ask. We gotta find all the information we can. Damn, maybe if we dig too much. I have to ask him about the broker.
What do you know about the broker?
He did this to me.
Specifics? What do you got?
I was hoping you'd know what he is.
I never got a good look, but he's big. The guards are terrified of him.
A Krogan?
I don't know, but not everyone who visits his office comes back out.
So, it's a full force living organism then, so it probably isn't an AI. Or it could be an AI, just in a big-ass mechanical thing. They're so intent on saying he. Everyone's saying he, so I think their game's pretty much confirming that before we even see the broker, that it's a he. I mean, we heard the voice, but that's a voice changer, you know? Anyone can sound like that with a voice changer. We're all leaving? For central operations, the broker's overconfident. Ooh.
If he left you alive for us to find, the broker has no idea how dangerous we are.
Don't underestimate him. He prepares for everything. Central operations is down the hall. You know the Shadow Broker's waiting for you, right?
I'm counting on it.
We'll be back for you, Farron.
I'll try not to go anywhere.
I want all teams to outpost C.
I'll try.
Paint the marks.
LOS, paint the marks. I want to read that update. Farron, don't you move. Stay calm.
Hostile.
Freeze.
The hell you think you're doing, madam? Look at her, we're about to bust her up, watch. She moved her head. What the fuck, Shepard? Okay, that cover's wild. Headshot! Get on up.
Yes.
Hold on, I want to change something. Where's Singularity? Let's do... Oh, we can't move it? That's fine. I really use throw more than Singularity. I'm thinking about... Or not throw. I'm thinking about upgrading pull all the way over Singularity for now. I mean, you think about it, we're getting pretty close to probably upgrading both of them at this point. And I guess depending on what... Yeah, I guess depending on what ability... Depending on what ability we end up using for our specialization ability or just extra ability. Because if we can use stasis, then we probably will use that, and I'll probably just one and done that ability. Because stasis seems more effective with just one point if you think about it. Because one point in a stasis takes him out of... What is it? Let's look. I'm nervous. So I'm prolonging. I'm fucking nervous, man. One point of stasis locks him down for 5 seconds. This locks him down for 7 seconds. So we're kind of just waiting there longer until the person to fall out of stasis. So 5 seconds is long enough. I mean, ultimately, all this really does is this stasis greatly increases the strength of stasis, allowing targets to be mobilized for longer. They'll be stuck in stasis even longer, which is counterproductive, I think. Enhanced stasis. Targets build up less resistance to stasis, allowing them to be affected more often. So, this will really only be affected in limited circumstances, as in a boss fight, probably. Something that lasts a while, maybe even a Krogan. But then again, I don't even think Krogans can last that long with us nowadays, because we're getting pretty powerful. I just think that's irrelevant, all of this. Just one point in stasis and you're good to go. If you want my honest opinion. And it's so valuable. Okay, shall we go? Still nervous. Oh, there is somebody up there. Hello. Nice to see ya. You can get there? Let's get there then. Oh, that was it. Shadow Broker. I think we just decimated most of your forces. Access terminal. Let's look at the journal though. Let's read this little update here. Get to the master control and free Farron from the torture device. Well, we had to shut the power off in the main place then. You guys ready? Opening doors is... What is that?
Here for the drill. Reckless, even for you, Commander.
Speak for yourself. I don't back down. Well, you should know that by now. Since you've been tracking us, you probably know everything about us.
That bombing on Ilium wasn't exactly subtle.
Extreme, but necessary.
No, it wasn't. Neither was caging Farron for 2 years.
Dr. Tassoni, your interference caused all this. Farron betrayed me when he handed you Shepard's body. The drill is simply paying the price.
Farron betrayed me when he handed you Shepard's body. So Farron had a lot to do with finding Shepard's body as well. Or Shadow Broker found us, obviously. Liara probably caught wind of it. Farron and Liara betrayed the Shadow Broker to get Shepard's body. All of it was for us, as always. Your allies are monsters! You're fucking finished. What are you?
Someone was bound to come after you for working with the Collectors.
It was a mutually beneficial partnership. Your arrival is convenient. The Collector's offer still stands.
You're assuming that you're gonna walk away from this. What? Very bold. You're finished?
Yeah. It'll be pretty hard to run a base this size with no crew.
They're replaceable. Your arrival is barely an interruption. Enough talk. My operations are too crucial to be compromised by a traitor.
You're quite confident for someone with nowhere left to hide.
You travel with fascinating companions, Doctor. It's good you brought Archangel to Sony. Your friend's bounty is still unclaimed.
You're not putting a hand on anyone.
It's pointless to challenge me, Asari. I know your every secret, while you fumble in the dark.
Is that right? You're a Yogg, a pre-space flight species quarantined to their homeworld from massacring the Council's first contact teams. This base is older than your planet's discovery, which probably means you killed the original Shadow Broker 60 years ago, then took over. I'm guessing you were taken from your world by a trophy hunter who wanted a slave. Or a pet. How am I doing?
Damn. You just got zinged, zunged, and many more words. Garrus. Oh, stasis don't work on him. Garrus, are you done? Where you at? It's only Liara here. Garrus kind of got jacked up front, so shit. Damn, let's- there you are, Garrus! Let's run? I think we're gonna need a different gun. Keep on. I think we're gonna have them. Oh, can we go up here? We're warping them. Shit, Shepard. Broker's fucking beast. We have to keep using cover.
The shield's kinetically sensitive. Energy and projectiles are bouncing off.
Then we do this the hard way.
I'ma fuck him up.
Him now.
Come here, you son of a bitch. That's fucking great. Damn, he pulled his shield out. This motherfucker has a shield. Singularity, maybe? Try to stop. Oh, yeah! Look, it knocks him off his balance. So, damn. This is gonna be interesting because. Let's keep moving. You fucking broke my cover, you ass! Leora, excuse me, I gotta run. He is just. Holy fucking moly! Send him flying, then, please. Damn, he's breaking all the cover! I think we gotta, instead of running, we need to really focus all of our weapons at him. As much as we can. Alright, run. All ass. We'll pillar hump his ass. That's the only way. And not get greedy then. Just keep going from cover to cover. Trying not to get greedy. You know, I can't get behind that cover. Shoot his feet!
This should slow them down.
There we go. Shadow Broker, you are badass. I guess this one? All the other cover over there is fucked up. He's vulnerable.
Get off cover. Come on. Go. Get off cover.
There we go. Come on, mother effer.
If you can get him to bring up that shield again, I've got an idea.
Yeah, I think I know what you're gonna do.
There they are.
There he is. Friends, we ain't got much cover here. Well. Let's keep throwing singularity on cooldown because it's not gonna back. Just keep tossing that shit. Alright, I'll ask. There's at least cover over here. Unravel his ass, Liara. I'm gonna unravel over here.
My shields are down.
Actually, look, poor Garrus is over there in the corner just chilling.
This should slow them down.
Damn, Shadow Broker. Let's throw singularity with Liara.
This should slow them down.
Yeah, it did. You don't know what to do. This spot's rough for you, isn't it? Singularity again, Liara.
I'll send them flying.
You're sending me flying. Alright, getting greedy. I'll send him flying.
We've got him.
We got him? Okay. Hopefully I can get to him in time before he recharges. Hey, Broker, how are you? Whoa!
Liara, now!
Bye-bye! The Shadow Broker is dust! That was so badass, Liara! Whoa! Garrus? Garrus? Where'd you come from?
Resume standard procedures.
I want a status report on all operations within the next solar day.
Shadow Broker, out.
Holy shit. Liara's the fucking God's Shadow
potions.
Broker now.
It's you. You... How?
Well, Everyone who's ever seen him in person is dead, so...
You're the new Shadow Broker.
Good. Good. Useful information. Holy shit. First thing that comes to mind, our girlfriend is the Shadow Broker. Holy shit. What the hell? Never expected something like this, but here we are. You need to expect the unexpected with Mass Effect, obviously. Okay, I figured like killing a Shadow Broker stopped the operations. I wasn't as suspected. We just take this shit over. Did you see her? Like a boss. Oh, that was such an awesome scene. You sure about this? Are you sure that you want to do this? Seems like a crazy job.
Is taking over as the Shadow Broker really a good idea?
It was either that or lose everything. His contacts, his trading sources, those will really help us. With the Shadow Broker's information network, I can give you...
I'll check the power systems.
See you guys.
It's over. It's finally. For 2 years.
It's just nerves. Hug her. Yeah. Hug her. Yeah. It's just nerves. See, this is like on the left side. It makes me wonder if this is just... What do you want to call it? Investigation? But it might not be. Okay? And we might miss the opportunity to hug her. So, in this situation, I would definitely hug her.
It's all right.
It's been 2 years. I don't... We're different people. You have your mission, and... Okay. Okay.
Okay.
But... We should focus. Let's see what our options are.
That was amazing.
No safeguards or user restrictions. It's like he never anticipated anyone but himself being here. And it's all ours.
Either that, or he thought to himself, if someone was powerful enough to kill him, then they have the right to take over. Maybe? As in his mind, there should always be a Shadow Broker? Maybe there should always be a Shadow Broker. Friends, we have so much information at our disposal right now. Literally. Whoa. What have we got? You can come with me. What have we got? I'm kind of curious to see what we got here. You can come with me. I'm holding out hope that we can say this too, but I really want to know what's going on.
What kind of information are we talking about?
I'm not sure. I'll need to go through his files. Come back later and I'll try to have something useful for you. All I wanted was to rescue Farron, but is it wrong that part of me wants this? With the Shadow Broker's network, I can help you. Maybe I can turn this operation into something better.
What if you find something on the Reapers that we never knew about, though? With the Shadow Broker's network, I can help you. She can! So much information now! Your mind, and your information, the elusive man's mind, and his information, we are unstoppable at this point. I'll miss you? I will miss you. Damn, we should have said the other one. Fuck all this and come with us. She wouldn't have. There's no way. This is too valuable to give up. And not only that, Leora is the type of person that thinks outside the box, thinks with a bigger picture. She needed to do this. Somebody needed to do this. Who better than her? I'll miss you.
Don't be a stranger this time.
Small chance of that. Come back soon.
But I don't want to go yet. Wow, what a DLC. Absolutely amazing. Seriously, though. Whoa. I'm a bit dumbfounded still. I don't know how to process this. Going into this, for all of us, as a blind experience. Did anyone ever suspect this? Liara Tassoni, the Shadow Broker. Like I said, maybe last episode or the episode before, the Shadow Broker to me felt like it was always going to kind of be a ghost. I never thought that we would end up seeing the Shadow Broker. And now we had a species on the Shadow Broker, something called a Yag, brief space flight species, so a younger species then. And the old Shadow Broker took it as a pet, and then it got strong enough and killed him. Or her. Shepard has defeated the Shadow Broker. Eliminate Cerberus information leaks as Liara Tassoni takes over. Yasari's relationship with Shepard should be watched closely. I don't think that's necessary, Lucid Man. You can watch it all you want, but I don't think Liara would ever do anything to go against Shepard. So we got pistol upgrade 30%, damage protection 40% bonus to barriers, armor, and shields. Credits. Oh my word, look how many credits that we got. Shadow Broker, who would have thought that you would be rich? 103,000 credits. Element Zero, 1,000. Palladium, 4,000. What a mission. What a freaking DLC. Oh. Oh, look, we're in Normandy. Exit, return to Normandy? No. I think...
Shepard, it's so good to see you. I've set up a few terminals with information I think you'll find interesting. Take a look.
Drone?
Welcome back, Shadow Broker.
What's this?
That's the old broker's VI assistant. It's actually been helpful with rebuilding the network.
Please let me know if I can organize anything else for you, Shadow Broker.
It also thinks anyone in the room is the broker. I'll play around with the settings later.
My manual is ready whenever you have a moment.
You're the new Shadow Broker. Wow, Theron was just as freaking dumbfounded. Hey, man, you crowding me here. Come on. Oh, we can go through them. They're fucking crowding me. Friends. What the hell? Oh, Liara, you gotta feel... Get the cover system back going on over here. Everything's crazy. Should we dig into the ship? And then talk to Liara last? See what the ship has to offer? Y'all seers? Investment opportunities? Yeah. I'm gonna dig into the ship first and then talk to Liara, I think. I think that's a good idea. Warning signal investment opportunities. A pirate fleet is massing on the fringes of the Terminus systems in preparation for a raid on outlying Alliance colonies. Send a tip to Admiral Hackett about the incoming invasion. Oh, Liara. Friends, that's literally one of the first things that came to my mind was just badass. Amazing. Among things. But one of the first things that I thought about was like, wow, she is going to do so good. She's got like a heart of gold. Her as a Shadow Broker is like... I know this sounds weird. But her as a Shadow Broker is like answering prayers. People, when they pray, they just get their prayer answered. It's basically like what it's gonna be, I feel. I feel like she'll definitely be shrewd when she has to be, of course. But in the ultimate bigger picture of it all, I feel like she's really gonna help a lot. A lot, a lot. The Shadow Broker is gonna... somehow just become very nice. 1,000 credits? Yeah, let's do it. What do we get for doing it?
The Turian Council member's mistress has made some unusual purchases lately. She may be expecting to move to a larger mansion.
Thanks, Info Drone. I always wanted to know about that. Is this mission in progress? A report would be... Oh, so it's time then. Interesting. I want to say bureaucracy, but... Yeah, bureaucracy. Bureaucracy in action. The Serta Foundation can't start tests on a promising new antibiotic because of accidentally misfiled paperwork. Use your contacts to help them cut through the red tape so they can begin clinical trials. 3,000 credits, ooh. What is the return of this stuff, I wonder? It's an investment. So you put some money down and then you get something in return. Let's buy it, sure. Interesting though. Smear campaign. Fucking Udina. Get out of here, you son of a bitch. A corrupt politician is trying to levy heavy taxes on all Earth manufactured goods coming into the system in exchange for kickbacks from local businesses. Ruin the politician's reputation with a smear campaign so that his proposal doesn't pass. Yes, please. Is this Udina, though? It probably isn't Udina, but it's probably someone up and coming like Udina. 2,500 credits? Yes. Let's smear his ass. Just reward. Eclipse mercenaries have secretly set up a red sand production facility on the planet Cero? Tip off the planetary authorities about the facility in exchange for half the credit seized during the raid. Ooh. Investment of 1,500 credits, and we might get at least more than that then. Let's do it, shall we? When will these be done? It says tomorrow, but how does the game do that? Excuse me, Jordan. I feel like I'm gonna have to walk around you. Dossiers? Oh. What is all this? Friends. This is a lot. Dossiers? Miranda Lawson? Is it gonna give us information on our squad mates? Got Morton, Jacob, Jack, Zaid, Garrus, Samara, Tally, Asumi, Thane, Grunt, Cerberus, Captain Bailey, Arya, Admiral David Anderson, and Stephen Hackett. Shadow Broker. Oh, stuff on the Shadow Broker. Friends, I want to read this first. Mail Archive. To Shadow Broker from Operative Ketchlu. Per your request, we've landed on the Yogg homeworld and captured a specimen for your studies. We actually had to kill several of them before finding this one, which seemed interested in leaving the planet. Hopefully this means he's more tractable. I do recommend caution, however, these creatures may indeed be valuable shock troops or bodyguards, but their savagery puts even the Krogan to shame. Are you serious? These Yogg, they're huge though. As near as we can tell, it's part of their culture. They're not simply brutes like most Krogan. The one we got is learning as fast as a Salarian. It could be more dangerous than you realize. So, they have a learning span of a Salarian, quick. You know, Salarians are so smart, they live like 40 years, just everything sped up for them. It's a mixture of a Krogan and a Salarian. The smarts of the Salarian, the brute of a Krogan. Oh, that's so dangerous. Oh my word. To Operative Ketchlu from the Shadow Broker. If you're reading this, my young friend, then you have eliminated the former Operative Ketchlu and have taken his position. These past few months, I've seen you learn and grow at a rate I would never have credited had I not seen to it personally. You've already understood 17 languages without translator assistance, and your political predictions have battered some of my best agents. As Ketchlu, you were command strike team to gather intelligence and neutralize potential threats. Remember your training. Losing your temper costs you that priceless mind of yours, as well as the loyalty of your men. The Shadow Broker leads those who look for secrets. He must be trusted by his men so that he can in turn trust them. Gathering information is a holy task. One, I'm sure you understand, as you wanted to be off your home world so badly to see what wonders awaited you out here. Please provide an update of all operation, Ketchlu, and know that I am proud of you. So he looked, the old Shadow Broker looked at this Yogg as a son, basically. To all from Shadow Broker. Remove Operative Ketchlu immediately. He is too dangerous to leave alive. Engage only with numerical superiority. Otherwise, change all access codes and observe only. Please, no information. Ketchlu must not be allowed any further access to message end. So he killed him. Took over. He's just too advanced. This species is too advanced. How don't they know spaceflight then? If their species is like this. Right? She said, The Yogg massacred the first contact team, basically, to all. From the Shadow Broker, Operative Chekyu is no longer a problem. Discontinue code changes and resume normal activity. I want a status report on all operations by the end of the next solar day. Shadow Broker, ow. That's exactly what Liara said. Whoa. That is absurd. Okay. The Yogg. Oh, we got something on the Yogg. The Yogg are a race of massive apex, yeah. Let's see what else we got. I want to explore first because it looks like, well, I'm hoping that we can come back to this ship whenever, because we can always come back to the ship and read more. Though I want to kind of read all these before we leave here, to be honest, because who knows when we'll actually come back. Oh, you're finished?
It's nearly time to repurchase effective caste status on Karshan. I have deducted funds to grant you full elite access.
Okay. Let's read about the Yogg first, though. Before we do anything else. Shadow Games, Shadow Broker Secrets, the Yogg. The Yogg are a race of massive apex predators from the world of Parnak, whose rise to sentience in no way blunted their violent nature. A group of Yogg is unable to cooperate until a single leader has been determined through either social maneuvering or brute force, but no grudges are held once a Yogg establishes dominance. Former rivals serve their new superiors' purpose with unflinching loyalty and relentlessness determination, a legacy of their origin as a pack species. Their eight eyes are another sign of their hunter ancestry. All four pairs are geared towards tracking down and predicting the movement of prey. Sophisticated and keenly developed sensitivity to movement and light have made Yogg's master at reading body languages, regardless of species. Much to their short-lived charge in the Council's first contact teams, discovered it was nearly impossible to lie to the Yogg. Friends, they're like the apex of evolution, basically. This species. I don't understand how they don't have spaceflight, though. The Yogg had technology equivalent to the 20th century Earth standards when they were first discovered by the Council in 2125. The Council's ambassadors approached the Yogg as friends and allies instead of subordinates, a baffling sign of contempt from newcomers on Parnak. The Yogg attacked when it became apparent that the alien diplomats stubbornly considered themselves sovereign people instead of new underlings. Parnak remains off-limits by order of the Council, which fears that the Yogg's size, aggression, and obsession with control makes them poorly suited for interrogation into the galactic community. But how don't they have spaceflight? They seem so smart. That kind of doesn't make sense to me, how they don't have spaceflight. We're gonna have to learn more on this. I hope they piece that together. Are they just not caring about spaceflight? Like, they want to stay in their own world, but they are literally probably superior to every race in the galaxy? I don't buy it. Something's gotta be more, right? Advanced training. Use. Oh, wait, what? This will allow you to redistribute the ability points for selected. Oh, we can respect the characters here. Respect all the characters that's not Shepard. At first, I just kind of don't really know who to respect besides Kasumi. We have to do Kasumi. For sure. We want her Master Thief all the way up again. Infiltrator was weapon. Oh, okay. Infiltrator. Power cooldown. Kasumi specialization in tech mastery greatly reduces the recharge time of her powers. Yes. We pick Saboteur to weapon damage. Infiltrator, we definitely need. I think we should. See, because Shadow Strike's really, really good. I really like Shadow Strike a lot, and it's really unique for Kasumi. But Overload is so good. What is upgraded Shadow Strike? Rapid Shadow Strike reduces the cooldown if the target is killed by this power. Increases the damage done when assassinating the target. Well, we're going to whoop 1 point in Flashbang. We can upgrade Shadow Strike all the way. I think we should. Because it's such a unique ability. Deadly Shadow Strike Rapid. Reduces the cooldown by 80% if the target is killed by this power. Yes, please. And then we'll put all the rest of the points in Overload. Just a couple points in Overload is still effective. It really is. It's going to go from 140 damage to probably, if we do heavy, 200. 60 points of damage. I gotta try this Rapid Strike. We have to. We can always respec her again. 1,000 element zero, though, that's kind of a lot. Who else do we want to respec? I don't remember. There was somebody else we needed to respec, though. Maybe? I don't know, actually. I think everybody else was pretty much good. Off the top of my head, it was just Kasumi. I feel like everyone else is good to go. Yeah. For now, we'll keep it how it is. Once we get them loyal, though. Yeah, once we get the squads loyal, then we might want to consider respecking. Because Tally has, like, the energy drain. Friends, we have choices to make. Lots and lots of choices here. We sure the fuck do. Because... this? Delivery pickup? Shipment Palladium, 5,000! A money laundering and recycling center has sent Palladium salvaged from old armor and cybernetics.
A Paladin agent has obtained the equipment used to record the General Partnax and Kilux Tanis duel. Well,
let's talk to Liara, I think.
How are you doing, Liara?
I'm a bit overwhelmed, to be honest. The Shadow Broker had more resources than you can imagine. Here, come on over. He had top-level access to the Turian and Asari governments. And more than one Solarian Dalatros traded intel. At least I get to share it with you.
Be careful, is it too much? It seems like it's a lot, Liara. You have everything you possibly want with information. Be careful. Let's tell her to be careful.
You're not gonna turn into a recluse with creepy information on everyone in the galaxy, are you?
I can understand the temptation. I've got all the secrets of the galaxy at my fingertips. Give me 10 minutes and I could start a war. But I've got a purpose. Helping you stop the Reapers. That will keep me honest. You know, relatively speaking.
It'll keep me honest. Relatively speaking. Is it too much, though?
If you're in over your head, we could just crash this thing and walk away.
That's just it. In a way, I feel like I belong here. Working on my own, I was always hunting for leads. With the Shadow Broker's resources, it's about organizing, cataloging. I've got everything, Shepard. This is a dream job. Although, the location could be better.
You can, well, I would say, just join the Normandy. I don't think she can at this point now. Man, that kind of hurts my heart. I just don't see it now. Because she's, like, who she is. She's so important. She's, like, the most important person in the galaxy at this point.
Have you found anything useful yet?
The Shadow Broker knew about the Reapers. Perhaps that's why he offered to help prove Saren's guilt to the Council.
He didn't want Saren to succeed.
He also knew that the Collectors were Protheans, repurposed to be Harbinger's puppets. There's even some data on the Protheans. I think he knew what was coming and was looking for a way to survive.
Yeah, but why? Though... Prothean data? Why hand us over to the Protheans then? Or Protheans, why hand us over to the Collectors then? If he had all this information, wouldn't he want to stop it all?
Why was he still looking at Protheans? They gave us the warning and the conduit at Ilos, but we've used those.
The Shadow Broker seemed to think there was more out there. Perhaps the Protheans had other plans. Or maybe he was just grasping at anything that offered some hope.
You gotta figure that the Protheans probably had many plans. It's just a matter of finding information on it. Friends, they had to have plans, backup plans, all types of plans. If the Protheans were this great apex of evolution race. Huh. Interesting. So the Shadow Broker thought that the Protheans had something else going on that isn't easy accessible to the eyes at the moment. I feel like that might be something. You gotta figure that the more information that we find out about the Protheans, the more will probably lead for information on the Reapers itself. Because, well, the Protheans were the last big species that was extinguished by the Reapers. Among other ones, probably, as well, but still. So the Shadow Broker is still looking for information on the Protheans, though. That's good. I mean, if anyone is happy about that, you gotta think Liara is. I mean, you know how she thought about the Protheans. Shadow Broker species?
How'd you know what the Shadow Broker was?
I didn't. I had no idea what to expect when we finally found him. But I researched pre-spaceflight cultures during some of my Prothean studies. I know a bit about the Yogg. There's more on the terminals if you want to look. They're a fascinating culture, and a terrifying one.
You could say that again. Farron's health? Yeah, how's Farron doing?
How's Farron doing?
As well as you'd expect, after 2 years of intermittent torture.
You gonna be okay?
I don't know. He wants to work, so I'm letting him help. Maybe it takes his mind off it.
Oh, this is a very forward question. Are you two together? Shepard, I think it's safe to say Liara loves you. Through and through. I don't have any doubts. Like, I was still curious about the relationship. I think everyone probably had to be. But we have no doubts now, yeah?
So, you and Farron?
Are just friends. I believe you made it clear that I was, as you humans say, taken.
I want to talk about us, Liara. Yes, I sure do. I believe you made it clear that I was, as you humans say, taken. Yeah.
You know, I didn't come down here just to talk about Data.
Look, about the kiss. We just finished the fight. I miss you, but it's been 2 years. I don't want to put pressure on you.
Let's just be friends, okay? No hard feelings? No! Let's just be friends! Probably breaks it up. Okay, no hard feelings breaks it up too. I do? Yeah, let's put some pressure on each other. Might be for good. Yeah.
I've got fond memories of the last time you put pressure on me.
So do I.
Why don't you come to the Normandy for drinks?
I'd like that.
Let's go now, we'll go soon. Oh, should we go now? Can we come back though? There's other stuff I want to read! I kind of want to see what else is on the ship. Yeah? Maybe if we say we'll go soon, we'll be able to like do things on the ship and then go with her after we're done. But then again, I think the investments or whatever we have, I think that's pretty much confirming that we probably can come back to this ship. Yeah, because it says come back tomorrow, basically. I think we should just go now. Because what happens if we say we'll go soon, and then that's it? Oh, I kind of want to see what else is on this ship, though. Damn it, I knew we should have talked to Liara last, but that's fine. Let's just go now. I don't want to fuck up anything if it would.
Good. Get your things and come on up.
Okay, thanks. I'll be right there. Just give me a minute.
Okay. Look at Shepard. You got the cheese! Laura's excited too. Just like old times on the Normandy.
Did you enjoy the tour?
Yes, it's a beautiful ship. And I ran into Joker. He seemed happy to see me. Although, he did ask me to record any parts of our conversation where my eyes do that freaky black eternity thing.
Of course he did.
Fuck off, Joker.
I also spoke with Dr. Chakwas. I'm glad she's doing well. I brought you something. It took some digging, but I recovered your tags.
Wow. Thank you. These aren't mine anymore. Yeah, once they're yours, they're always yours, Shepard. It's a part of you.
I thought I'd never see these again.
You can't get back everything you lose, but sometimes you get lucky.
Yeah, that was the plan.
How are you actually doing, Shepard? I mean, really. Not what you tell your squad to keep morale up.
Well, the first time in who even knows how long, someone just actively asked Shepard how we are doing. How amazing is that? I feel like that is little things like this is what truly make games amazing. Because not many games just go back and sit back and say, ask the main character how they are doing. That's awesome. I'm worried. I'm hopeful. I'm frustrated. I'm worried. Liara? All that shit going on is worrisome. We're worried about losing people. Worried about not succeeding. Worried about the Reapers. We're probably still worried about you. As the Shadow Broker, it seems like a lot on your plate.
Between you and me, I have no idea how we're gonna do this. I'm doing everything I can, but...
You've done more than most. There wouldn't be a man, woman, or child left on Horizon, if not for you.
Too many still died? It was a damn setup? It was. That's the crazy part, it was a setup.
You know the worst part of it? Cerberus planted intel to lure the collectors there. Horizon was bait.
Those bastards.
They'd have hit another world if we hadn't lured them there, but... Aren't you gonna tell me not to work with them?
I gave them your body, remember? What should I say? And I trust you. You'll stick to your beliefs no matter what Cerberus wants. So tell me what you want. If this all ends tomorrow, what happens to us?
Happy ever after? Death, most likely? Happy ever after? Just going in the sunset with Liara, friends? Could you imagine? Seriously. Can you just imagine it now? Could you imagine Shepard and Liara, after all this is done, basically getting our own planet, let's just say. We got our own planet. And then the scene goes with Shepard and Liara holding hands or something, I don't know, looking at a sunset. In the background, we see the Normandy just take off. Like, we're done. Like, retired. You know? You can picture it now. Happy ever after, yeah.
I don't know. Marriage, old age, and a lot of little blue children.
You just say these things. Goddess, you were dead.
I got better.
This time, but you're going to leave again. When your team is ready. You'll leap through the Omega 4 relay.
Yeah.
I spent 2 years mourning you. So if we're going to try this, I need to know you're always coming back.
Make me an offer? Ooh, I like... That sounds poetic. Done? Dunn is like, Shepard's like, you damn right I'm coming back, baby! Make me an offer sounds so intriguing.
I don't know. That's a pretty big promise to make.
Oh, is it?
I'd have to have something special to come back to.
I'm open to suggestions.
How about... this?
Yeah, I said the thing again.
Thank you, Shepard, for the drinks and everything.
Come back soon, Liara.
Come back soon, Liara. I miss you already. Just stay. It's okay. I think it's okay. I think now we understand that Liara, I don't think she can come back to Normandy. At least not now. Friends, did you see Liara's outfit? And Shepard's over here wearing a fucking leather jacket.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Hey, Kelly. How are you?
How may I help you, Commander?
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Let's read the message, talk to Joker, and see about stasis ability, and then we'll call it. Though, I actually want to click on the map again and see if we can go back to Hot Galas? Peepers? Oh, I'm an old fan of Vermeer. Actually, let's read this one, and then we'll... I think we're going to read a lot next episode. I really do. Because if we can go back to the Shadow Broker ship, then yeah. Blood pack facility detected. Plan information, Zeta Ban, Zcha system, Strike Abyssal. We have decrypted and analyzed the data you recovered from the relay on Tereth. The resources mined on Tereth were being sent to Zeta Ban, presumably for use in weapons manufacture. It is clear that the Blood Pack is planning a large-scale invasion. Disrupting the operations on Zeta Ban will go a long way towards delaying or preventing this invasion. Captain Kiri? Oh, I kind of want to read it all right now, actually. We might as well. From Captain Kiri. Remember Kiri? The first game? This cool-ass Salarian, hold the line, and he points up to the sky. Fucking best speech ever. Shepard. Glad you're alive. Hope rumors of death were exaggerated. If Vermeer couldn't kill you, I doubt much could. Yeah. Got word from Morton that he's active again with you. He's requested some classified data to help with countermeasures for stasis fields using in the human colony attacks. I work with him on special task groups. He's a good agent. Nervy for a tech. Bit of a cloaca, though. Cloaca? What the hell does that mean? I didn't get permission to investigate attacks on your human colonies, but I'm asking around anyways. If I find anything useful, I'll send it your way. Hold the line! Kirihi. I guess he feels indebted to Shepard for saving him and his team. Probably for life. And he'll always have our back. Oh, that's really awesome, Kirihi. I hope to see you again sometime. It could happen to you. Alcos male rooting. A drone lay in the ocean, dying from Keppel syndrome, and had a dream. In his dream, the Enkindlers came to him and charted the course of his life. The Drow saw the wakes and eddies and saw that sometimes the Enkindlers swam alongside him, limbs racking the water while other times he was alone. The Drow saw that the times he was alone were the hardest times in his life. He asked the Enkindlers, why was this one abandoned? What is this? The Enkindlers answered, their light shining brightly, you were never abandoned. In those difficult times in your life, it was our bodies that bore you through the water. The Drow awoke and found his careful syndrome cured. If you follow the light of the Enkindlers, it can happen to you. Where the Enkindlers go, we shall follow. And where the light is, the sun, we shall be the stars around them. Send this message to six beings of your acquaintance, and your greatest wish shall come true. Oh my god, it's like spam mail. Fucking spam mail that you would get on like Facebook or some shit like that. What? Let's even go back even farther and say MySpace, huh? Shepherd Space. Concerns Keepers. Chorbin! Oh, remember the Keepers that we scanned in the first game? Chorbin! I hope this address still works. I promise to send you intel on the Keepers if I found anything. And this is important. See those scans you took? It turns out the Keepers are bioengineered, and based on my comparison to some of the materials from Saren's flagship Sovereign, they were engineered millions of years ago by the same people who made Sovereign. Wait, the fuck? Wait, are you telling me that something came before the Reapers? Something made the Reapers, and they also made the Keepers? Oh, this is huge. There's something more than the Reapers then. Oh no. That's like screaming a foreshadow into like Mass Effect future. Yeah? Stop the Reaper threat maybe, but what's after the Reapers? Oh shit, that's huge. You may not understand how important this is, but it suggests that the Citadel wasn't really made by the Protheans. It may have been made by something far older, with the Keepers as organic guardians. And what's more, based on my genetic readings, they're supposed to react to something, some signal or something, about every 50,000 years. You can measure genetic variances. It's a bit like comparing rings on a tree to see the drought years. Whoever did this, well, around the last time the signal went off, would be the same time the Protheans disappeared. And it's scheduled to go off sometime around now. If any of the old tech still works, they could have some nasty surprises waiting for us. Just thought you'd want to know, and nobody here on the Citadel will listen to me, Chorbin. Of course they weren't. Reapers, they're definitely not going to listen to you. So, for sure, if we didn't stop the Citadel relay from happening in the first game, then the Reapers would already be here destroying everyone. Which is interesting to me because I feel like that, by just the knowledge that we know, I feel like the Protheans were way more advanced than what we have now. It's almost like if the Reapers want us at their apex, you know, of evolution, then you figure they would probably wait longer, yeah? I mean, we are in spaceflight though, so maybe we are at the apex that we could probably get. Really cool. Let's talk to Joker. Hey Kelly, let me see something actually. I gotta see if we can go back to... Oh, the Shadow Borker base, we can just go back to it whenever. That is extremely good. Amazing, actually. We can go back and read all that stuff. There was actually another room back there, too, that we didn't click on. But we couldn't just... We couldn't turn Liara down, yeah? Or wait, have her wait. 30% pistol damage upgrade, let's do it. Anything else? Heavy pistol critical. Heavy pistols sometimes deal double damage. Oh, so it's going to deal double damage now. That is kick-ass. So 25,000 palladium and we have 508,000. Yes, please. I think it's safe to say we should keep on upgrading stuff. Armor. Damage protection. Squad bonus 40% through shields, barriers, and armor. Yes, please. That would make it... Oh, that's 4 of 5. But wouldn't that make it 5 of 5? Nah, that was 4 of 5. Weapon upgrade, no. Armor upgrade, emergency shielding. Unity restores squad members' shields to full health. Oh, okay, when we use Metagel, everyone's shields to full strength. Let's do it. 25,000 palladium, we still have a shit ton, let's just say. Armor upgrade again, hard shields. Shepard's shields take 20% less damage. Yes, please. Great! Very great. Nothing more in weapons. Prototype, advanced training, retrain powers. Let me save, okay? Let's do a save real quick. Because last time we tried to get an ability, it wasn't there. So, let's see. Retrain powers, advanced training. Stasis is there, baby! Shepard's getting stasis, it's over. Reapers are done for. Barrier and flashbang, let's get stasis. I'm gonna miss barrier, I really will miss barrier a lot. Because, just... It's barrier though. Let's respect too. Let's respect real quick. While we're at it. Let's retrain powers. We have 23,000 element zero. This costs 2,000, and that one costs 5,000. So we'll retrain our powers, okay? Obviously, we're gonna do the mastery again. Oh, look at our Paragon and Renegade went down. It's because we don't have the plus 100. We're gonna do Bastion again. Look at it just go up. See ya. Let's put 1 point in the stasis. Warp is always gonna be upgraded all the way. Heavy warp. Singularity. Two in singularity. We're gonna go all the way and pull. I think. So heavy pull duration is 12 seconds. They just dangle in the air for 12 seconds. 9 seconds dangle in the air and the radius is 3 meters. Friends, pull the field might be really effective. Seriously, because even if we can't pull the target, they kind of like, it kind of staggers them a little bit. So let's do pull field. And we can do singularity as well, so no throw and no shockwave. Yes. Oh, that was a really great idea. Wide singularity and heavy. We're going to go back to heavy singularity. Because at this point, I feel like heavy is so much better. We really just use singularity to block targets. I don't even use it really to lift people anymore. It's kind of just to block targets and stagger a bit. I feel like singularity in the first game was so much more useful. But in this game, singularity has its niche usefulness. As in, I really just feel like it's mainly useful for blocking and locking targets down. It seems like it does strip a little bit of their shields and such, as it does damage. But we'll do heavy. And then at this point, we'll just keep going with throwing shockwave. Shepard, I feel like you're pretty much done. You're really beastly at this point. Oh, that's so cool. Let's go talk to Joker so we don't miss anything, just to see if he's excited about the eyes doing the freaky black thing, he said. Well, Liara and Shepard are, I think, officially back together, friends. I think that's, obviously, I don't just think. I mean, that's what we're doing. That's our relationship.
Commander.
What do you think about the people we're picking up?
Well, about the ones you went out with last. It seems like Garrus has finally worked that stick out of his butt, but now he's trying to beat guys to death with it. I can't believe I like the old Garrus better. It's just my opinion, though. There's really no need to go spreading it around.
Oh, you didn't say anything about Liara? Damn.
I assume everything is going well up here?
Good for now. Fractured my thumb on the mute, but I think I made my point.
Doodles, Joker.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
All right, my friends, I'm going to save here, and when we get back, I want to head back to the Shadow Broker ship. I want to explore it. I want to take it in. I want to read all them dossiers on our companions, see if we can learn more about them. And then maybe, if we leave the Shadow Broker ship and go back, the investments will be there. Oh, that's such a unique little thing. I really like that. Actually, one more thing before we head out. I want to go to the room. I want to see if Liara had put anything unique in the room that's interesting for us. Look at this picture. I really love that that picture's there. Friends, it looks like we can get a few more of them things here. These, models. There's our dog tags right here. Well, it's safe to say at this point, if there's an option to romance other people in this game, I don't think I'm going to do it. I think Liara is our love, my heart. I don't think I could do it. I don't think I can be that type of person to her. I just can't. Yeah, I had them feelings. You know, Tally was giving me butterflies. Just cause, you know, we really miss her, you know, we miss other people. All of our companions. We miss them all. But I just don't know if anyone can give me them feelings that Liara has at this point. Has gave us. And I just feel... it just feels so right. Shepard, Liara. Continuing from the first game. And I'm not the type of person that could run around on somebody too. I just couldn't do it. So I think at this point, if there is options to romance other people, I don't think we are. I think that was our romance. Basically. What we just did with Liara, I think that was our Mass Effect 2 romance. I want to stay true to her. I just don't know if I could fully do something like that. I love Tally to death. I do. But that might be for another playthrough. Maybe flirting, of course, will be fine. But if there's options to make sure we don't into romance, probably the best thing to do. Yeah, it might be a little spoilery. But I think Atticus's heart is just for Liara. That's just how it is. But anyways, my friends, I'm out of here. Have a good one. Stay safe. See you next time. Take care.